गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल एडवोकेट अमित कुमार गुप्ता। इन माय सीरीज ऑन द इनकम टैक्स केसेस, द केस विच आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज डिप्टी कमिश्नर ऑफ इनकम टैक्स वर्सेस सनप्लैक आयरन एंड स्टील कंपनी लिमिटेड। दिस केस हैज बीन रिपोर्टेड इन 96 आईटीआर ट्रिब्यूनल शॉर्ट नोट्स पेज नंबर 9 एंड दिस मैटर हैज बीन डिसाइडेड बाय नागपुर आईटीएटी एंड द डेट ऑफ द जजमेंट इज 29 अप्रैल 2022। फ्रेंड्स, एज वी नो दैट देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ लिटिगेशन ऑन सेक्शन 147-148, मेजोरिटी ऑफ द लिटिगेशन इज ऑन दिस सेक्शन बिकॉज द डिपार्टमेंट हैज गॉट वाइड पावर अंडर दिस सेक्शंस एंड द सेक्शंस आर ऑल्सो वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स। एवरी टाइम द लेजिस्लेचर इज ब्रिंगिंग अमेंडमेंट्स इन दिस सेक्शंस एंड ट्राइंग टू कवर अप इट्स ऑफिसर्स थ्रू अमेंडमेंट्स इन द सेक्शंस। Same issue came in this particular case, which is related to the assessment year 10-11 and 11-12. In this case, the assessee was producing electricity and at the same time, it was into the business of steel business. When the electricity was produced, the electricity was consumed for its steel plant also, and the excess electricity was being sold to the government, state government. The assessee was claiming ATIA exemption on the electricity part, and the department was allowing to the assessee in the previous years, and the assessment of the assessee was also completed under section 143 subsection 3 in the previous years also. It means that the department has, on the major front, has adopted and was with the assessee on the ATIA exemption. For the assessment year 10-11 and 11-12 also, the assessee claimed ATIA exemption and got its assessment completed under section 143 subsection 3. But after that, the assessing officer reopened its case under section 148 and disallowed the ATIA exemption on the plea that the assessee does not have separate electricity unit, and the electricity unit and the steel unit is the only one. It is a combined unit. So on this basis, the assessing officer said that you cannot claim ATIA exemption, and the addition of 38 crore was done. The assessee went to CIT appeal, but the CIT appeal gave the relief to the assessee. That's why the department headed towards the ITAT, and ITAT held that this is not a matter of reassessment, it is a change of opinion. This was a clear-cut case of a change of opinion, because not only in this particular year that the department has accepted the version of the assessee of ATIA, because the questionnaire was issued, the assessee explained all the points and the assessment under section 143 subsection 3 was completed by admitting the ATIA exemption. And apart from this also, in the various years also, the same version was accepted by the department. So ITAT said that under section 148, you have the power to reassess and not to make a change of opinion, because this is a clear case of change of opinion. When in the various years you are accepting that the assessee is eligible for ATIA exemption, and all the facts have been brought by the assessee on record in the normal assessment proceedings, so just for your completing fantasy, at any time you cannot reopen the case and keep the litigation open all the time. If this will be allowed, then there will be no use of the concluded assessments, and there is always a fear in the mind of the assessee that any time I can lose my ATIA exemption or any deduction or something like that. So this case is very important and gives a clear message that section 147 and 148 does not allow change of opinion. It only allows reassessment in case when there are genuine cases where the department feels that there is escapement of income for the failure on the part of the assessee not to disclose truly and fully all the facts to the department. Friends, this case is very important in dealing with section 148 notices, especially where the assessment is reopened after 4 years and the assessment of the assessee has been completed under section 143 subsection 3. At the end of this deliberation, I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is Deputy Commissioner of Income Tax versus Sunflag Iron and Steel Company Limited. Thank you, friends.